or three get together in my name, that he's right there with us. And so our endeavor is to experience God. And one of the ways that we do that is through prayer. And it's an emphasis of our church. We have three group prayer meetings. We also teach you how to pray and emphasize that because it's so crucial. And this beautiful weather that we're experiencing today is a result of prayer. We've been praying for this for 2 months in our prayer meetings. So God answers prayer, and he's always faithful.
We're excited about children. We're excited about you guys and adults, but we're also excited about children in this church, because when you begin to train a child at a young age, they hear what you're saying, they're listening to everything that you're saying, and they soak up things like a sponge. And so it's very important that your children are trained in the ways of the Lord. And so encountering God, experiencing God for children is a wonderful thing. And we love training children. So the thing about it is, we are to encounter or experience God. The best way is for the child to come to church. Isn't it nice to have a place for your children to be that's safe? Man. You know, it's really true that the world is difficult and the world is hard. So you need a safe place where a child can be trained. Another thing is, for a child to encounter God, they need to come to church. Have you ever noticed when music starts playing that immediately a child starts dancing, starts clapping? Nobody sees that? That's what happened. When the music starts, kids go crazy. And that's what it says in the Bible in Psalm 100, says to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. And that is what children are created for, to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. So we teach them and we train them about praise. We teach them how to be positive young children. Positive young children grow into positive adults. How many want positive teenagers? Oh my goodness, don't you? Yeah. So you teach them from a young age how important they are, how much God loves them, and you teach them to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. That's how they experience God. That's how they learn how much God loves them. Bob and I are the pastors here at the Gulf Coast Christian Center, but we didn't know everything on our own. We needed help. We needed to learn how to train our children, and that's what the church is about. And we're so happy that you're here, and we bless you today.
Hi guys, how you doing? My name is Christian. I am on staff here at the Gulf Coast Christian Center. So what we're doing real quick, we're gonna have a little snapshot of what we have available here at the Gulf Coast Christian Center. So that was our senior pastors, Pastor Bob and Candy. And you're about to hear from a few more people on pastoral staff. And we just wanted to talk about the vision of this church. Our vision at the Gulf Coast Christian Center is that you would encounter God, find community, and fulfill your purpose. And so right now, I'm talking about finding community real fast. Sorry if I look like a hot mess. Some of the volunteers, we've had a very interesting morning this morning. But I'm sure some of you guys had a crazy morning too. How weird was the weather? Just quietly, what happened? It's like freezing outside. But a lot of work has gone into preparing this for you guys, and we're just so honored that you would come. We're so excited that you came to be a part of our community this morning, and we just want to bless you and bless your families. And I hope that today, you and your family, you make a bunch of memories, and you go outside, and you have an amazing time. So I'm holding in my hand a Bible, and some of you are like, what? No, this is a Bible. And I think what I wanted to say was, this is really just a lot of stories that are an example of people's lives. You know, there's no formulas in here. You can't just take the Bible and not understand it and apply it to your life and have a good life. Honestly, I'm just being honest for a second. This is just a bunch of stories of people who tried things and it worked for them. People who encountered God mightily. We've got examples of people who made bad decisions, what happened in their world. We have people who make good decisions, what happened in their world. And I guess what I wanted to say is, how many of you know this book can be really confusing, right? Have any of you ever read Deuteronomy? What? What is happening in Leviticus? What is happening in Numbers? It can all be pretty confusing. But I think that that's the beauty of the house of God, is that we get to come together and we can talk about this in light of the context of what it meant to the people of the day. And then we can take these principles and take these attributes and take the wisdom from this book and apply it to our lives. You know, I was reading the other day, and they were saying that the most lethal relationships in your entire world is your friendships. Because human nature, we hate getting rejected, right? That's not just a me thing, right? We hate getting rejected. And whenever someone accepts you, you let your guard down. You let that person speak into your world. Young people, listen to me for a minute. Your friendships are very important. Who you choose to surround your life with. I was reading another thing, and it was talking about how the five people who you spend the most time with influence your destiny more than anyone else in your life. And I guess I wanted to say that we aren't perfect here at the Gulf Coast Christian Center. We are broken people headed towards a beautiful Savior, and we're vulnerable with our stories and with our journeys. And if you wanted to come and be a part of our church, if you wanted to come and experience life with us on a weekly basis, we would love to unpack the Word of God with you and to be in community with you and to be in community with your children, and that we could just walk this journey towards Jesus together. And so I guess I just wanted to encourage you guys along the lines of finding community here at the Gulf Coast Christian Center. If you want to come back next week, we would love to see you, 10:30 a.m.
Good morning. My name is Joshua. This is my wife, Jamie.
Hello.
We are on staff here at the church. That's why we have these cool little pictures on our name badges. And this is, like I said, my wife, Jamie, and she prepared all week for this moment. So she wrote it down, and I'm going to let her read it off her paper because she wants to get every single word right just for you guys. You're that special.
Well, the Gulf Coast Christian Center has been my family for my entire life. I'm 24, so that's 24 years that I've grown up here in West Columbia. So it's hard for me to even imagine what life would have been like without this place, because I've grown up here and shared so many moments here that are so important to me. Growing up, my family consisted of me and my mom. My dad passed away when I was super young, so it was just me and her, only child. So I had always wanted a big family, and so coming here and building relationships gave me that desire and that I'd always wanted. I found that when I surrounded myself with people that were building their goals and living life, that it made me want to do the same thing, and it helped me be a better person. You know, when you put yourself with good people, it helps you want to become a good person. Makes sense. So, coming from a small town, we live in West Columbia, population, 5,000 people? I don't know. Coming from a small town, but going to this church, it helped me not stop myself from having big goals and big dreams. Because, like Pastor Beebe always said, you can go anywhere in the world from here, and I have literally done that through this church. So the Gulf Coast Christian Center has really shaped my life, and here is where I am fulfilling my purpose.
Yeah, and a little different from her, I've only been here for about 6 years, but I did find her here, so that was awesome.
You can find your soulmate here.
Yeah, come to the Christian Center, you'll get married. No. And so I've been here for about 6 years, and I've definitely, in my time here, learned about the purpose God has for my life, and I've been able to walk in that, and I've not completely fulfilled it, I believe, but I am fulfilling it. As I became a part of what God's doing here in this place, I've been able to do things I've never thought I would be able to do. I've traveled all over the world. I've been to Thailand, Haiti, Africa, England. I've been all over the place. And that was all because I didn't know what to do. I didn't have every step planned out. All I did was dare to trust God and to say, all right, if this is what you have for me, then I'll do that. And I'll just each step of the way he's led me. And so I would encourage you this morning that if you're thinking about coming to the Christian Center and making this your home, that you do that, because it'll challenge you, it'll help you grow as a person, it'll grow your family, it'll grow your relationship with God. And so I just want to encourage you guys, like she said, we're all getting it together, and that's just something that we're believing God for, that he's fulfilling the purpose in each of our lives. So thank you so much for letting us talk to you. We appreciate it. I think we have a video for you guys.
My name is Julia Walker, and I am the children's leader on Sunday mornings. I just want to share a little bit about you, about us, but Wild Ones, our theme verse is Galatians 5:1, and it states that we have freedom now because Christ has made us free. And ladies and gentlemen, I just want you to know that that is our heart, that is our passion for your children, is that we're raising up young and mighty women and men of God who are free, and that they know that their identity is found in Christ. And I wanted to read Proverbs 22:6 in the Amplified version to you real quick. It says, train up a child in the way he should go, teaching him to seek God's wisdom and will for his abilities and talents, and even when he is old, he will not depart from it. And so I just wanted to let you know that we love your children. We have a passion for them. And I want to personally invite you to come join us Sunday mornings at 10:30. We'll meet in here, and then we are in the Firehouse Youth Ministry. And we just love the kids, and we are so excited that you are here today. And this is Miss Gabby.
Hi, my name's Gabby, and I am the leader for the Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. And I just want to let you know that we are so excited to be able to invest in your children, because they are worth it. And you know what? Our God is a fun God, and that's what we get to do with the wild ones. Julie said we are free, so let's have some fun and let's be free. Let's learn about Jesus, how he is with us when we're in a time of need, and when he's with us when we're happy. Because you know what? The fact is that Jesus is with us. And you know, we get to have fun, we get to play games, we get to have lots and lots of excitement. So I just want to invite y'all out, because you are worth it, because Jesus died for you, because he loves you. And I want y'all to know that you are so capable of having experience with God. All you have to do is just try, and he is faithful to answer you. So come on out on Wednesdays at 7 o'clock and Sundays at 10:30.
My name is Jacob Walker, and I'm a sixth grader at West Columbia Elementary. It is my privilege to be able to speak with you this morning. Today, I want to talk about knowing Jesus. The Bible tells us in John 3:16, that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So first of all, knowing Jesus will bless you with eternal life, going to heaven with him. It also tells us this eternal life is open to whoever believes in him. So do not think that's not for you. It is. God loves you that much. He sent Jesus. Jesus lived a perfect life and never did anything wrong. Then, as part of God's plan to save us, Jesus died on the cross for us. That was the payment for our eternal life. The Bible also tells us in John 10:10, the thief comes to kill, steal, and destroy. But I've come so that you may live life and life abundantly. There really is a devil, and he really hates you. He wants to kill you, he wants to steal everything you have and destroy your life and your eternity. But the second part of that verse, Jesus tells us he wants to give you an abundant life. He wants to take care of all of your needs. Philippians 4:19 says that may God shall supply all my needs according to his riches and glory in Christ Jesus. I'm not very old, but I've seen God do great things. He healed my mom of cancer. He sent me and my friends to orphans in Haiti and changed lives. He has provided for my family. He has saved my friend from a life of drug addiction. He has given me words to share with my friends who are hurting. All of these things and much, much more I've been able to experience because I have a relationship with Jesus. I hope that all of us know Jesus and have a great relationship with God. The good news is that you can have the right relationship with Him. And I'm going to tell you how. It's easy. All you have to do is ask God to forgive you of anything that you've done that's wrong. 1 John 1:9 says, if we confess our sin, He is faithful to forgive us of all of our sin and to cleanse us from all of our unrighteousness. So if we pray and ask God to forgive us, He will. So let's pray. If you want to know Jesus and have a relationship with Him, pray this with me. Dear Jesus, I know I have done wrong. Thank you for dying on the cross for me. I want to follow you in all the days of my life. Come live in my heart and make me new. If you prayed with me and meant what you said, you are saved and have God's attention. The Bible says all of heaven rejoices when one person gets saved. God made it that easy on purpose. He made it the good news. So now that you are saved, to have a great relationship with God, we need to spend time with Him. We need to get to know Him. To do that, we need to read His book, the Bible. We need to talk to Him and pray. We need to meet with His family, the church. Thank you for letting me share with you today. I hope you have a great day and have a great relationship with Jesus.
On the city streets, but I can hear that you're calling me to be the hope, be the light, be the love right now. Start it right now.
Hey! Hey!
Yeah, it's my first time. My name's Melissa, and I'm bringing a piece of paper to you. And I second that with Lauren, I really do. I actually showed up on this doorstep with two little babies in my arms as well.
my babies and I were about to move into a shelter in November 2014. I'm going to try not to cry. So we were going to move into the shelter. I had grew up in an abusive home and was just raised that way. Spiraled into abusive relationships myself as an adult. And Valentine's Day this year, Pastor Tommy Tenney came in and preached a message about God's protection. And that was the last day that I chose to be a victim of domestic violence. His message basically showed how God takes the enemy out of your life and how he covers you. And he did that just for my babies and I and for a lot of people here. You see the sign on the front door, it said, "Welcome home." Well, that's what happened to me. I was welcomed home. This home is for me. It's for my children. This is where it all began. In this town, I actually gave my heart to Jesus. I graduated from West Columbia. When I come here, this church is a place that I feel safe. It's a place I trust. This ground is anointed. As soon as you come here, you know that you're going to receive a message from God, and you can apply it to your life, and your life is going to be in a better state the next day. You have protection, and I needed protection, and I got it. I've been blessed so tremendously in leaps and bounds. My education is increasing. My children are healthy. They're happy. They're thriving. I am healthy, happy, and thriving. I'm getting my real estate license. Everything is coming together, and it's to the glory of God and this church and the people who are in it. This church is my family. They're my blood. I have friends that are family who took me in as well at this church. When you come in, you're joining a family that loves you, that honors you, covers you in prayer. I gave everything. I gave my testimonies, my tears. I give them my babies to help me raise. I don't know how many of you come from a single home or in a single parent situation right now, but this is the greatest place to get plugged into to help raise your children in and become just a better person in God and in the community. With every message, with every prayer meeting, service to the Lord and worship service, fear fell off my life. Heartbreak. I actually felt my heart heal from all those years of abuse. In this church, my heart just sewed up and is whole. It's just supposed to run smoother, but anger's gone. I don't know how many of you deal with anger because of a lot of the rejection and abuse that you might have endured, but that is lifted. That's gone. It's all peeled away, and I want to give God the glory because not only is it peeled away in my life, but it's peeled away in my four-year-old's and my two-year-old's life as well. The scripture says for generations, it's peeled away from their lives as well. I've gained trust, compassion. I've always had compassion, but they showed me compassion, and that gave me the trust. And that having trust and fear relieved will take you to different levels in your life that I recommend all of y'all get plugged into this church, get connected. God speaks his messages through this church and through the pastor, and they're all for, those messages are for all of us to glorify God and to grow up in him and to grow our babies up in him and grow this community up in him. Everybody here truly loves you. They truly love you, and I truly love them.
Thank you, Melissa. Well, I grew up in this church, and of course, my dad was a pastor for almost 50 years, and Pastor B.B. Hankins, a great man of God, and grew up, was taught the Bible, and had the right example set before me. But when I became a teenager in college, I got away from God and began to wander away from God, and decided I wanted to have fun for a while, and began to party and, you know, just kind of go my own way. But when in my mid-20s, I found out that I wasn't happy, even though I was doing all the things that, you know, the world says should make you happy. I wasn't happy. And some folks have an ideal that if you live a life of sin, you're going to be happy. But it's really just the opposite. You know, and folks who should be happy because of all the things they're doing aren't happy. And so I recommitted my life to Christ and got back on the road to serving God, was called into the ministry, and here I am. So I found out that living for Jesus is the best way. Well, not just to go to heaven. Some folks think, well, the ideal life would be to live a life of sin and then, you know, get forgiveness on your deathbed and go to heaven. That would be the ideal life. But Jesus said, I came to give you an abundant life. The best life is living for Jesus all your life. And you can find true happiness in serving him. And so you heard Jake pray the prayer, the sinner's prayer. You know, Jesus died on the cross for our sins. And so none of us can be good enough to go to heaven. We have to have forgiveness of sins. And we get that through Jesus Christ and asking for forgiveness. And so we believe in what he did for us on the cross and make Jesus Christ our Lord and just pray a simple prayer that, Jesus, I give my life to you. Forgive me of my sins. I'll serve you all the days of my life. And it's just really, it's really that simple. So if you haven't done that, I encourage you to do that. Jake's already led everybody in that prayer. So you can do that later on your own. But living for him is the best way. And so as we end today, I want to say that we have a connection tent out in the yard. And if you want to know more about accepting Christ or get connected to the church, you can go to the tent. We also have free cards for the iPad giveaway, which is going to happen next Sunday, that you can get at the tent.